Hey everybody, welcome back to another video here at the Washington Football Maniacs. Please, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to this channel. Like, share, comment, do all that fun stuff, and we're going to get into it right now. So, the debacle of the Sean Taylor ceremony this past weekend. All right, now, I was not at the game, so I can't really comment firsthand, but from what I heard, and I haven't really... Honestly, I hadn't had a chance to sit down and watch the ceremony. I know that it was on YouTube or Twitter, but I have not had a chance to sit down and watch it yet. But having said all that, I've heard that it was a very short ceremony. It really felt like it was rushed, felt like it was just kind of pieced together at the last minute. And a lot of people felt that that's what the case was anyway, since it was just announced. What was it, like a week ago? Even though there are reports saying, no, this had been in the planning for months, but I don't know. Maybe it had been planned for months, but then kind of, you know, put on the back burner for one reason or the other. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh no, you know, we're supposed to do this this weekend. I mean, think about it. Sean Taylor's number being retired, this is a huge thing. I mean, Sean Taylor is one of the greatest Redskins to ever play on this team. And I'm saying Redskin because that's what he was. He played for the Washington Redskins. And, you know, here's the thing. Yes, I know that Sean Taylor's life was cut short. And, you know, I realized that he didn't have a very long career in the NFL, but... people could see right away this guy was going to be special. He was a generational type of player. A player you just don't see very often come around the NFL. And he was probably the best player to ever play that position. And in just a short while. Can you just imagine, had Sean Taylor not, you know, had an unfortunate, tragic end to his life so early, if he would have played... even 10 years in this league, you know he would have been a Hall of Famer. I mean, he would have been a shoo-in to be in the Hall of Fame. You know, I would have just hoped, of course, that he would have played all of those years in Washington. But, you know, having said all that, many fans have been very upset with how they felt that this was such a monumental, important thing. And it was. And it just felt rushed, you know. Then we had Patrick Mahomes' brother dancing on Sean Taylor's 21 and saying that he didn't mean any disrespect and all of this. And oh, he may not have, you know, I'm not going to judge, but it was in very poor taste. Very poor taste. Should not have happened. Nobody should have been allowed to be standing on Sean Taylor's number 21. Nobody should have been. It was just disrespectful. Well, if it was meant to be or not, it was. The second thing, I saw the pictures on Twitter, and you know, the pictures with Sean Taylor's family at the Sean Taylor road, and they're getting their pictures taken in front of porta potties. I mean, come on. You had all this time, you were planning this for months, and you did not have the foresight to see, hey, we want to take this picture right here at his road sign. Maybe we should think about moving those porta potties somewhere else so we can get a good, tasteful picture with the family. Just as what that family deserved. They did not deserve to have their pictures taken in front of porta potties. I mean, come on. It's just, that one really bothered me. You know, other fans commented on Dan Snyder, you know, not dressing up for the pictures and wearing, you know, a hoodie. And you know, that's kind of become Dan Snyder's, I'm not going to say motto, but I guess that's kind of become his style of dress in the past few years. He's went from being the suit and tie to he wants to be one of the guys wearing the hoodie type of owners, which is fine. I honestly didn't worry about that as much. I mean, yeah, it would have been nicer for him to have, you know, dressed up in a suit and tie, but I'm not really as upset over that picture as I was the porta potty picture. I just felt that was another disrespect as well. You know, it's just, sometimes I just wonder about this franchise. I mean, and you know what really makes me worry even more is the fact that they don't pay attention to detail. How does a franchise, how does any business become and stay successful? They pay attention to the fine details. They don't leave any stone unturned. They don't, you know, they don't just assume anything. They go after everything. They think of everything, every scenario, anything. And when it comes to something like this, you know, pictures taken in front of porta potties, having somebody dancing on Sean Taylor's number, you know, not dressing up for these special photos. I mean, it's just attention to detail that is not there in ownership. And I don't know if it's going to be any better with, you know, Mrs. Snyder being in charge right now. So far, I mean, I haven't seen it. And this, of course, goes into not ownership, but, you know, coaching as well. You got to look at very fine details. And I think that's what separates the great coaches, the elite coaches, from the rest of the pack. You know, Bill Belichick, love him or hate him, he almost has this OCD thing when it comes to detail. There is such fine attention toward detail with Bill Belichick that it's things that you don't even think of. And then he's like, oh, he's thought of it. You know, because he knows the rules. He knows how to, you know, use that rule to his advantage or to stretch it to this point that people had never thought, hey, I didn't realize you could get away with this. I mean, it's fine attention to detail. Joe Gibbs was the same way back in his prime. He paid attention to fine details of the game, which is the reason why that the Washington Redskins won 3 Super Bowls with Joe Gibbs. It's the reason why that the Patriots won, what, 6 Super Bowls with, 6 or 7 Super Bowls with Bill Belichick as head coach. Yeah, of course, Tom Brady, but, you know, that's beside the point. You know, my point is in this video is that when you look at how Sean Taylor's ceremony was short, rushed, just didn't look like it was a ceremony that honestly it should have been hyped up much more than what it was. It should have been this huge thing because Sean Taylor was this huge player, not just physically, but just, you know, in every sense of the term. The guy was just, he was larger than life on the field. Deserved much more than what he got on Sunday. It's my opinion. I know that is opinion of a lot of fans. That being said, hope you enjoyed this video. I know it wasn't a very happy video. Here lately, it seems like a lot of, you know, Washington football team videos have not been very happy because we're losing right now, but let's see what happens when we go against Green Bay this coming weekend. Anyway, like I said, like, share, subscribe if you can, and I will see you in the next one.